If both of you would answer this, you played in that under 23 international tournament. Just talk about the benefits of playing in that and how maybe that helped each of your games.
I would say just getting real games during the summer. That's something that a lot of colleges don't get. Obviously, it's just usually weights and conditioning and then limited hours of practice. So I think just getting games under us, and especially international competition, is way different. And then getting to play alongside some of the best college players in the nation, I think that really helped my game a lot personally.
Yeah, I agree. It's the best of the best that were there this summer. And I mean, learning from the best coaches and I mean players, it was just a good experience, and I think helped us grow. We went in with a mindset that we don't know everything, and just to take everything that was said and that we learned in and apply it to our team.
Freddy, Holly was talking about, you know, that defense is being stressed, and the numbers suggest that needs to happen. Can this team get better defensively given how many young players you have working into the system this year?
Yeah, definitely. I think so. I think our practices have been great, just as Holly was talking about, very competitive, and we've been working hard on the defensive end day in and day out, and we're going to continue to do that every day because this season defense is going to be huge for us, and it's definitely going to be a priority.
Yeah, I don't think we've really made defense as big of a priority as we have this year. We really focused a lot on just making sure everybody knows what they're supposed to do and everybody is taking care of basically their person and that we're helping each other. So we're not playing defense just one person. We're all five playing defense together, and we're doing everything that we can in order to stop the other team, basically, and we're really working together.
To both of you, the roster is kind of a weird dynamic with some seniors leading the way and a lot of freshmen as well. I'm just wondering, how have the freshmen blended in so far to just kind of the team dynamic?
They've blended in really good. I think freshman year is difficult. I think we've been there, so we know how it is, especially just now, just practicing all the time and really just learning a lot. I think that's something freshman year is. You have to learn a lot and kind of come in with an open mindset and take everything that players before you and coaches teach you. So I think that's where they are right now. Obviously, it'll be different when we actually play games and play in a competitive schedule, but I think they just have taken in what we've said and are really eager to learn. They ask a lot of questions when they don't understand it and are really just wanting to get better, and that's something that's new here. They're in the gym, and that's just nice to see.
So one thing that Holly kept on way back here, sorry. One thing that Holly kept on talking about was how you all stepped into this new role for yourselves on the team. How do you kind of view your role this year with this team?
Well, for both of us, we obviously have to be leaders. We're both seniors, and we've been here for a while, so we're kind of the seasoned vets on the team. So just in every possible way, helping the freshmen as much as we can, but also bringing everyone together and just leading the best way that we can.
Last year, y'all beat three of the teams in the Final Four. I think you lost six games to teams that missed the tournament entirely. How do you kind of develop that consistency that was missing last year? Why was it missing last year, and how do you kind of develop that?
I think the consistency aspect that we're missing was because of our lack of leadership. And, I mean, you see some of the best teams, and their leaders are the hardest workers and just are doing everything they can to win, and I think that's the difference between this year and last year. Sadie's and I are working our hardest, are trying to be great examples. We know we're not perfect, and we're also able to listen to other players when they have questions, when they have things that they want to tell us personally about what we're doing, we're also listening. So not only being a player that can do certain things for the team, but also somebody people can approach and that people trust is in the gym and working as hard as they can. I think that's the biggest difference.
Mercedes, Holly said that you're more physical and more demanding. Is it in your nature to be demanding?
I guess so. Yeah, I know kind of this year my role has to be huge. also just me and Jamie have to be playing big every single game. We're going to have to do a lot, probably leading, scoring, rebounding, and then every other aspect that we can. But yeah, I definitely spent a lot of time in the weight room this summer and just on the court, just trying to improve my game as much as I can and getting stronger at the same time.
Question for Mercedes and then for Jamie. Mercedes, you're a fifth-year senior. You could have been a top three, at least, draft pick in the WNBA, but you opted to come back. For you, why did you come back for your fifth year? And then, Jamie, you mentioned leadership. It's not easy. It is a hard thing to undertake and to do. What made you rise to the challenge this season to step into that role?
You want to go first?
You got it.
Well, honestly, I came back just to spend another year as a Lady Vol. I mean, being in college and being a Lady Vol at the same time is an experience that you can't really share with everyone because everyone doesn't get the chance. But I came back for me, but also for the team, and just knowing the freshman class that was coming in, they're going to be very talented, but on top of that, they work hard. And they're going to be a great group of kids, but also just coming back and just hopefully making my last year the best year ever.
I think something that I've learned as I've gotten older, pretty old, is that the best teams have the hardest working leaders. The leaders are the hardest workers. So I think that's just something that I've learned as I've gotten older. I think that's why teams are so successful, and that's a reason why we haven't been. And I look at my freshman year and Izzy, and you had Sierra and Ariel who all worked hard. So I think we had a pretty good run then, but I think we could have an even better run now just because of how talented everybody is and just the work that everybody puts in. So I think that starts from the leaders of the team and trickles down. If we're working hard, if we're in the gym and everybody follows, if we decide to work out with somebody, if the freshmen decide to work out with one of the coaches, then everybody's going to follow that. So it's not that, that's, I think that's just something that we've kind of learned, and which is why we've kind of stepped up in our leadership role this year.
All right, Mercedes, I want to talk about double doubles and 19 last season. Obviously, Candace Parker has the school record 21. How important is the double-double to your game, and how much do you want to break Candace's record?
Well, I honestly didn't know that was a record, but it's definitely important to me, not just for me, but my team, because that's me helping my team in every way that I can. But it's definitely a goal of mine to average a double-double. I was so close last year, so that's definitely a goal this year for me.
Jamie, Tennessee's been picked fourth in the SEC, and some people don't pick Tennessee to be in the top 25. Is that a motivating factor for you?
I really don't think it matters. I mean, you look a month or 2 months in from now, the top 25 changes. I mean, you could care what people in the media or whatever polls have to say, or you could just work as hard as you can and focus on what you have to do. So I think that's what we're doing. I mean, people can say what they want about our team, about any team, but at the end of the day, it doesn't matter. It matters how you play when you step on the court. So I think it doesn't matter. I mean, what we are now, what happens when you get to SEC and what happens after the SEC, that's what matters as far as the tournament and how far you go.
Along those same lines, though, I know you guys, you stressed this in Nashville, and Holly did here earlier about, you know, the past is a past, we're moving forward. But do you feel like as seniors, are you guys motivated by the last 2 years? I mean, those clearly are two seasons you guys didn't achieve the things that you wanted to do. I mean, does that fuel you guys? Does that inform you in terms of how you want to approach this last season?
Yeah, definitely. Obviously, the past couple years, we haven't lived up to standards, and it's definitely motivation for us as a team just to do better and go as far as we can this season.
I think the biggest thing with the past couple years is just what we've learned from it. I mean, not to be in that situation again. And I think it's a whole new team, which is why it's so much, why we have so much potential and why we have so much, or a different perspective on this year. And I think that's what makes it different, because we've learned so much and we're trying to teach the players that are here now, the new players, to not be in that situation again, to come in every single day and be consistent. And we can't have days where people don't want to practice or people don't feel like being there. We're just not together, and that's just something that we've had to learn. And I think that we're getting there. Obviously, we still have young players and players that really haven't experienced that, but we're definitely learning that as a group, that we have to come in every day ready.
Thank you.
Thank you.